major challenge for designing drug therapeutics currently is that much of what we know about disease mechanisms comes from animal models or simplified cell culture models. And so what our lab does is we design advanced 3D models of human tissues in order to recreate disease mechanisms in a petri dish. And so we actually focus on the biology of adipose tissue, which is actually difficult to culture outside of the body because it doesn't have the structural integrity. And so in order to overcome that challenge, we create these human adipose tissue models in a silk scaffolding material. And so we extract the silk from the cocoons of silkworms, and then we use it to create a porous 3D sponge for the cells to live in. Our work could lead to new discoveries on how human diseases develop. For instance, determining what the trigger is between the transition of obesity to an insulin-resistant type 2 diabetic. We also envision that we could use our models to start exploring individualized healthcare strategies, where a small amount of adipose tissue could be used to create a patient-specific model in the lab. And then we'd use these models to screen different therapeutics to determine effectiveness and also different optimal doses. While currently we are working on using these models to explore mechanisms of diabetes progression, it's not limited to that disease process and could actually be used to explore weight loss strategies or even to explore other diseases that are related to changes in the adipose tissue, for instance, cardiovascular diseases or breast cancer. The long-term goal of this work is to create more complex three-dimensional human models in the lab in order to replace the current models that are used, which are animal models and don't have as much human physiological relevance. We are currently actively using these models to explore disease mechanisms, and we hope that they will provide predictive insights soon. Our work is very interdisciplinary in nature, and it has the translational potential to be used preclinically or clinically. We're also at the interface between material science and biomedical engineering, and we hope that our work will have significant impacts on both of those fields.